Hello friends, welcome back to All About Structural Analysis and Design. In this video, we shall learn how to do an estimate of single-storied building by long wall and short wall method. In the previous video, we have learned how to estimate for a two-room building by the long wall and short wall method. We have learned the basics in the previous video. In this video, we shall have the detailed estimate of a single-storied building which is having a dining room, a drawing room, bedroom, kitchen and toilet. So we shall have a detailed estimate in this particular problem. Hope you like our content. Please like, share and subscribe to All About Structural Analysis and Design. So let us begin the problem.
The problem is given as, here we have a plan of a single-story building which has a drawing room, dining room, bedroom, kitchen and toilet. So the dimensions are as follows. It is 4.2 by 3.5 for drawing room as well as dining room. For bedroom it is 4.2 meters by 3.2 meters. For toilet 1.8 meters by 1.7 and for kitchen it is 2.1 meters by 3.2 meters. The plan has been, it is having doors, windows and also the ventilators. The schedule of opening is given as follows. Doors D is 1.2 meter by 2.1 meter. D1 is 0.9 by 2 meter. Windows is 1.5 meter by 1.4 meter. Ventilator is 0.6 meter by 0.45 meter. The section is given at a particular window here. The section is given as follows. So we have a stepped footing with PCC of breadth 0.8. Then we have a stepped footing for 3 steps, which is 0.60, 0.50 and 0.40. The wall thickness is given as 0.3 meters. Plinth level is given as 0.6, which includes the flooring thickness of 2.5 centimeters. Then we have the steps of length of 2.5 meter and height of each step is 0.15 and breadth is 0.30 of each particular step. As per the section, we are having an accessory slab and above which we are having the parapet wall of 0.7 meters height. So while doing the calculations, we have to consider all these part. Now let us see what all we need to calculate. So as per the problem, we need to calculate the earthwork in excavation, sand filling in the plinth, PCC bed concrete 1:4:8 for foundation, first class brick masonry in CM 1:6 in foundation and plinth. First class brick masonry in CM 1:6 in the superstructure, mosaic tiles flooring 12 mm thick inside plastering in CM 1:4 for internal walls and ceiling, 20 mm thick outside plastering with first coat in CM 1:4 and second coat in CM 1:1 and woodwork for doors and windows. So these are the things which you need to calculate. So we'll consider each item separately and calculate the quantities there. So when we see the plan, in the long wall and short wall method, we need to convert the plan into long walls and different short walls. So when I see the plan over here, all the longer walls are of same dimensions there. So it is, if I consider 1, 2 and 3, so there will be 3 long walls. But when I want to consider for the short walls, I cannot consider in the same manner because in the bedroom, toilet and kitchen section, we have 1, 2, 3 and 4. There are 4 walls there. When we come for drawing room and dining room, 1, 2 and 3, there are 3 short walls. So we cannot consider the same numbers as that of the long wall. For that sake, we'll divide the plan into different sections there. For calculating long wall, I'll consider it as a main building and I'll have 1, 2 and 3 long walls. But for calculating the short walls, I'll be considering 2 separate areas there, wherein the first area I'll consider it to be drawing room and dining room and the second part as bedroom, toilet and kitchen there. When I consider drawing room and dining room, I'll be having 1, 2 and 3. 3 short walls. And then we'll be considering for this rear portion, bedroom, toilet and kitchen, we'll be having 1, 2, 3 and 4. 4 number of short walls. But we have left up with this particular wall, the toilet wall here. So that we'll be considering it as a long wall. So long wall, which is of 1.8 meter into in dimensions, this part we'll be considering for the long wall. So considering all this, we'll calculate center to center length. Now let us see how to calculate the center to center length. Main building long wall center to center length is given as 0.3 by 2 plus 4.2 plus 0.3 plus 4.2 plus 0.3 by 2. So how are we going to get that? So if you see the plan here, in twin dimensions of the drawing room is 4.2. To that we'll be adding the wall thickness here 0.3, and the in twin dimensions of the dining room is 4.3. So when we need to calculate the center line from the center of the exterior wall to the center of this exterior wall. So when I need to calculate the center line, it is half of this wall thickness and half of this wall thickness to be added to the length. That is what is written here, 0.3 by 2 plus 4.2 plus 0.3 plus 4.2 plus 0.3 by 2, which is 9 meters. So for the main building long wall, we are getting it as 9 meters. With a similar concept, we will be calculating the short wall distance for the drawing and dining room. Short walls center to center distance is given by 3.5. So into in dimensions for the drawing room, here it is 3.5. 3.5 plus 0.3 by 2 of this wall and plus 0.3 by 2 of the other wall, we are getting it as 3.8. So for the drawing and dining room, the short wall center to center distance is given by 3.8. So to calculate the center to center length for the long wall in the rear portion, for the toilet we have end to end dimension as 1.8 meter. So half of this wall thickness and half of the other wall thickness. So 0.3 by 2, 1.8 plus 0.3 by 2, which is 2.1 meters. A long wall distance for this portion is 2.1 meters. Coming for short wall center to center distance. So here the breadth is given as 3.2, half of 0.3 and half of 0.3. When we do, we are getting it as 3.5 meters. So we have calculated the center to center distance for the main building long wall and for drawing and dining room, then rear portion long wall and the short wall distances. Now we shall plot up the table wherein we can calculate each and every item separately. Serial number, description of items, number, length in meters, breadth in meters, height in meters, quantity, and then the calculation part. The first one is earthwork in excavation. While doing earthwork in excavation, we will consider main building, then drawing room and dining room, rear portion with the long wall and short wall. So just now we had calculated the center to center length. Using those particular length, we shall calculate the quantity part. So long wall. So how many long wall for the main building we have? 1, 2 and 3. So 3 numbers of the long wall. Then what is the width of the excavation there, how much width we or the breadth of the excavation we need to go, which is 0.8 meters. That's what we have written here as 0.8 meters. Coming for the height of the excavation. So below the ground level, up to what height we need to excavate it? 0.3 plus 0.3 plus 0.3 plus 0.2, which is 1.1 meter. Now we shall calculate this length. How did we get it as 9.8? So we already know that the breadth portion is 0.8. So our long wall concept, it is the center to center length plus the breadth part. So 9 meters plus 0.8, which is 9.8 meters. That is what is written over here. Now next, coming for drawing room and dining room. Again, we are going to repeat the similar thing, but for the short wall, the center to center distance minus the breadth part. So center to center distance for short wall for the dining room, we have it as 3.8 minus of 0.8, we are getting it as 3.8 that is written over here. How many short walls we have? 1, 2 and 3. So 3 short walls, 3 meters length, breadth of 0.8, height of excavation is 1.1. Then coming for the rear portion, how many long walls? It is 1. So one number of long wall. Then calculation of length here, center to center length is 2.10, but here we'll be doing minus of 0.8. Already the excavation length has been considered in these particular short walls. So I need not add for the long wall for the toilet. So I'll be deducting this particular portion. So it is 2.1 minus of 0.8, which is 1.30. 1.30 is the length in meters. Breadth is 0.8, height is again 1.1. Coming for short wall, in the rear portion, 1, 2, 3 and 4. There are 4 numbers of the short walls. Then calculation of length, center to center length is 3.5, minus of 0.8, which is the breadth, we are getting it as 2.7. That is 2.7. So, the breadth part 0.8, height again 1.1 meters. So we need to multiply these to get the quantity. So for the long wall is 3 into 9.8 into 0.8 into 1.1, which is 25.872. Similarly, for the drawing room and dining room of short wall, we are getting 7.92. And for long wall, for the rear portion 1.144, for the short wall 9.50. I need to add up all these quantities to get the total quantity of the earthwork in excavation. We are getting it as 44.44 meter cube. Now next, we need to calculate sand filling in the plinth area. So for the plinth area, we have to calculate how much the sand filling has to be made. So usually the sand filling will be made inside the rooms here, not below the walls. Below the walls will be having the columns and then we'll be having the foundation. So inside the rooms part will be having the sand filling there. So for those we need to calculate the quantity. So when I'm considering sand filling in the plinth, I'll be considering each and every room separately and then calculate the total quantity. So for drawing room and dining room, as the dimensions of drawing room and dining room are same, here I have written number as 2. Length is 4.2 meters, breadth is 3.5 meters. Now coming for the depth part. So, if we see in the plinth section, the height of the plinth is 0.60 meters. Then, which includes 2.5 centimeters of the flooring. So, I have to deduct this flooring part to get the depth of sand filling or the height of sand filling. So, 0.60 minus 2.5 centimeter there. So, 2.5 divided by 100, 0.025. That is written over here. So, 0.60 minus 0.025, which is 0.575. I just round it off to 0.8. So we have written here height as 0.58. The same height will be there for all the rooms also. Now next, for the bedroom part, when we come for the bedroom here, the dimensions are given as 4.2 meters by 3.2. The length is 4.2, breadth is 3.2. Kitchen, it is 2.1 by 3.2, so length is 2.1, breadth is 3.2, toilet it is 1.8 by 1.7. We are left up with the passage portion. The length of passage is 1.8. Now, regarding the breadth part, how to calculate this? The breadth of kitchen is 3.2. 3.2 minus 1.7 of toilet and minus of this particular wall thickness will give us the breadth of the passage. So that is written over here. It is 3.2 minus 1.7 minus 0.3, which is 1.20. So 1.20 is the breadth for the passage. We need to multiply these. So 2 into 4.2 into 3.5 into 0.58 will give us 17.052. Similarly, for the bedroom, kitchen, toilet and passage, multiply these items to get the quantity. We need to add up all these quantities to get the total quantity. So, total quantity we are getting as 31.7724 meter cube. That is the quantity required for sand filling in the plinth. Next, coming for the PCC in the foundation. So PCC in the foundation, the length for the PCC in the foundation will be same as that of the excavation, because we are having the breadth of 0.80 for the PCC. So the length will going to remain same as we have calculated for the excavation. Only change will be the height. So height of PCC is 0.20. The height is going to get vary here. So 0.20 is the height there. Now 9.8, how did we get that? Length is 9 plus 0.8, which is 9.8. Similarly for the other calculations also. There are three number of long walls. 3 into 9.8 into 0.8 into 0.2, we are getting 4.704. Similarly for the other rooms also, for the other dining room and drawing room and the rear portion, we will be calculating all these by considering the height of the PCC as 0.2. When we see the length, it is same as the earthwork in excavation, which is 9.8 for long wall, 3 for the short wall, 1.3 for long wall of the rear portion, and 2.7 for the short wall. We'll add up all these quantities, so we are getting it as 8.08 meter cube of PCC in the foundation. Next, we need to calculate first class brickwork masonry in the foundation and plinth. So when we see the section here, we are having the foundation with the three steps there, first, second and third. And also we are having the plinth portion with the height of 0.6 and the width there. Wall thickness for the plinth is given as 0.30. Also we have the steps. So by considering the first class brick masonry in foundation and plinth, we should calculate for the foundation, for the plinth portion and also for the steps, the quantity of the brickwork required. Coming for the main building, again for the long wall and for drawing room and dining room, for the short walls, then the rear portion we need to calculate. First step is having the breadth of 0.60, then 0.50 and then 0.40. The first footing is 0.6, 0.5 and 0.4. For the plinth it is 0.3, so which is 0.3 written over here. Then regarding the height of each particular step, so all these three steps are having 0.30 of height, so 0.3, 0.3 and 0.3. Coming for the plinth, height of the plinth is given as 0.6. So that is what is written over here. Now we need to calculate the length. While calculating the length, our concept remains the same here, center to center distance plus the breadth part. So for the first step, the breadth is 0.6. So 9 plus 0.6 is 9.6. The next one, it is 9 plus 0.5, which is 9.5. Then 9 plus 0.4, which is 9.4. And 9 plus 0.3, which is 9.3. We have three numbers of long wall for the main building. We need to multiply these 3 into 9.6 into 0.6 into 0.3. We are getting 5.184. Similarly, we will be doing for the other steps and the plinth wall. Now coming for the drawing room and dining, short wall, it is, we are having the center to center length as 3.8. 3.8 minus of 0.6, which is 3.2. Then 3.3, when we do minus 0.5, minus 0.4, then minus 0.3, when we do, we are getting 3.5. We need to multiply these number, length, breadth and height, we will be getting the quantity. Then coming for rear portion, long wall, it is 1 in numbers and the length is 2.10, which is the center to center length, minus of 0.6, then 0.5, 0.4 and 0.3, we will be getting 1.5, 1.6, 1.7 and 1.8. When we multiply these, we will be getting the quantity there. Next, going for the short wall, we have 4 number of short wall in the rear portion. Then, for calculations of the length, it is 3.50, which is center to center length, minus of 0.6, which is 2.90, then minus 0.5, which is 3, minus 0.4, which is 3.10, minus 0.3, which is 3.20. So we are getting 2.93, 3.1 and 3.2. When we multiply these 4 into 2.9 into 0.6 into 0.3, we are getting it as 2.088 meter cube. Next, so similarly we will be doing for second, third and plinth wall. Now coming for the steps. When we see the plan there, we have the length of the step as 2.5 meters. So the length is 2.5 meters. Now coming for the breadth part. When I consider one particular step, it is from this portion to this particular portion. So it is 0.3 plus 0.3 plus 0.3, which is 0.9. The breadth of the first particular step is 0.9. And height of each step is given as 0.15. That is 0.15. Coming for second step, it is 2.5. Now breadth here. From second step to the plinth part, so 0.3 plus 0.3, which is 0.6. Then for the third step, it is 0.3. So 1 into 2.5 into 0.3 into 0.15, we'll be getting the quantities. So when we multiply these numbers, length, breadth and height, we'll be getting the quantity. So for first class brickwork, in foundation, plinth and step, we need to add up all these particular quantities. Then total quantity will give us the brickwork in the foundation, plinth with the steps there. So we are getting 33.585 meter cube. Next, we shall consider first class brick masonry in the superstructure. While considering the brick masonry in superstructure, we need to add up the parapet wall also. So for the main building long wall, 3 numbers. For calculating the length, 9 meters center to center length plus the wall thickness of 0.3, which is 9.3. Length is 9.3. Breadth, that is a wall thickness of 0.3. Height of the superstructure up to the RCC slab, it is 3 meters. So when I multiply 3 into 9.3 into 0.3 into 3, we are getting 25.11. Now for the short wall, 3 in numbers. For the short wall, it is 3.8 minus of 0.3, which is 3.5. So length is 3.5, breadth 0.3, height is 3 meters, I'm getting 9.45. For long portion, for the rear portion, long wall, 1 in numbers, 2.10 minus 0.3, which is 1.8. For the short wall, 4 in numbers, length is 3.5 minus 0.3, which is 3.2. The length is 3.2. When I multiply these, I am getting the quantities as follows, which is 25.11, 9.45 for the short wall, for the rear portion long wall 1.62, then for the short wall it is 11.52. Now considering the parapet wall, height of the parapet wall is given as 0.70. So, height is given as 0.70, which we have written over here. For calculating for the parapet wall, we need to consider the outer portions or the outer walls. So, I divide the plan into 2 long walls and 2 short walls here. So, considering the long walls, out distances here, the center distances will be calculating. So, that will be 9.3, which is plus 0.3 plus 4.2 plus 0.3 plus 4.2, 0.3 and 0.3 on the other side. So, we are getting 9.3 as the parapet wall for the long wall. When I consider the short wall here, we are getting length as 3.5 plus 0.3 plus 3.2, which is 7. The short wall is 7 meters. When I multiply with the breadth and height, we will be getting the quantities as follows, 3.906 and 2.94. Then the total of the brickwork for superstructure will be 54.546. But in the plans, we'll be having doors, windows and ventilators, which we have to deduct there. So the deduction part, door openings D and D1. So as per the schedule of openings, D, the length of the door is 1.2 and height is 2.1. Door D1, it is 0.9 and 2. Then for window, it is 1.5 by 1.4. Ventilator, it is 0.6 by 0.45. Breadth is the wall thicknesses. So, which we have written it as 0.3. Doors, number of doors there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. So, we are having 6 number of doors. D1, it is 1 in number. Then windows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, we are having 6 numbers of the windows, ventilators 1, 2 and 3. There are 3 ventilators present. So, when we multiply the numbers length, breadth and height, we are getting the quantities. So, for calculating the net quantity of brickwork in superstructure, we need to consider the total brickwork minus the deductions part. That is 54.546 minus the total deductions, which is 9.099. I am getting it as 45.447 meter cube. So, the brickwork required for the superstructure, after the deductions, we are getting it as 45.447 meter cube. Next, we are given that we have to calculate the quantity of mosaic tiles for the flooring. So, when we are considering for mosaic tiles flooring, each room has to be considered separately. That is drawing room and dining room, as the dimensions are same. I am considering it as two numbers, 4.2 by 3.5. Then bedroom, 4.2 by 3.2 one number. Kitchen, 2.1 by 3.2. Toilet, which is 1.8 by 1.7. Passage, length is 1.8. Then regarding the breadth portion, the 3.2 minus 1.7 of toilet minus 0.3, which we are getting it as 1.2. So, this will be regarding the mosaic tiles. Then we have to add up the door sills. So, when we are adding the door sills, how many doors are there? There are 6 doors D in numbers. That is D, 6 numbers. Then D1, which is 1, 1.2 by 0.3, 1.2 by 0.3, that is the wall thickness there. So, when we multiply these, we will be getting the quantities. And when we add up all these quantities, we are getting 57.21 meter cube. That is mosaic tiles flooring quantity is 57.21, which is meter square. So many meter square of mosaic tiles flooring quantity is required. Then coming for the 12 mm thick plastering for internal walls and ceiling. So when we are calculating for plastering of internal walls, each particular room is considered separately. In each room, we are going to divide it into long wall and short wall. Then calculate the number of walls, multiply it, we'll get the quantity there. And then for the ceiling also, we have to consider it each room wise and multiply the with respect to the area there. So now for drawing room, it is long wall. So two long walls, two short walls. So long wall, which is 4.2 and 4.2, short walls 3.5 and 3.5. So two long walls, which is 4.2, two short walls, which is 3.5. So, up to what height we have to consider? Floor to floor height, it is 3 meters. So, when I multiply this 2 into 4.2 into 3, which I am getting it as 25.2. Similarly, we have to do for dining room, which is of same values. Coming for the bedroom, it is 4.2 by 3.2. We are getting the values here. For kitchen, it is 2.1 by 3.2. We are getting these values. Then for toilet, it is 1.8 by 1.7. The quantity for the toilet, it is 10.8 and 10.2. Coming for the passage, long wall distance. So here, it is 1.8 plus 0.3 of this wall thickness and 0.3 of the other wall thickness, which is 2.4. So length is 2.4 and the breadth part is 1.2 for the passage. So, we are getting quantities 14.4 and 7.2. Coming for the ceiling part, each and every room has to be considered separately. Drawing room 4.2 by 3.5. Dining room again 4.2 by 3.5. Bedroom is 4.2 by 3.2. Kitchen 2.1 by 3.2. Toilet 1.8 by 1.7. Passage 2.4 by 1.2. When you multiply these, we are going to get these particular quantities. When we add up all these quantities, we are getting the internal plastering, which is 266.7 meter square. That is the quantity required for the internal plastering. Coming for the external plastering, that is outside plastering of 15 mm, we have to consider again main building, long wall, short wall. When we are considering for the external plastering there, so, we have to consider the out-to-out distances, considering to be two long walls and two short walls there, and steps. For these steps, we have to consider different steps, first, second and third, and do the calculations for those. And for the external walls, whichever doors and windows will be coming, that we need to deduct. So, coming for main building, two walls, two long walls and two short walls. The length here, which is 4.2 plus 0.3 plus 4.2. But and both the side wall thickness is 0.3 and 0.3, which is 9.3. So, we are getting it as 9.3. Similarly, for the short walls, 3.5 plus 0.3 plus 3.2 plus 0.3 and 0.3 on the either side of the walls, which we are getting it as 7.6. Then height of the wall, which will be complete height from the floor to floor plus with the 0.7 of the parapet there. Considering that, the total height will be 4.45. When we multiply these, we are getting 82.77 for the long wall. For short wall, we are getting it as 67.64. Then coming for the steps, first step tread, it is 1 in number, length is 2.5 as given in the plan. Then the breadth part, it is 0.3. Coming for the riser, we need to calculate the length there, which is 2.5 of the length and 0.9 and 0.9 on the either side. 2.5 plus 0.9 and 0.9 will be getting it as 4.3. So, 4.3 is the length for the riser. The height of each particular step is given as 0.15. So, coming for second step, again for the tread, it is 1 in numbers, 2.5 by 0.3. Then coming for the riser there, it is 2.5 plus 0.6 and 0.6. When adding, we'll be getting it as 3.7. Then the height is 0.15. Coming for the third tread step, it is 2.5 by 0.3. Then it is 3.1 as the length, which is 2.5 plus 0.3 and 0.3 on the either side, which is 3.1. When we multiply these quantities, we are getting it the total as 154.325 when we add up all these particular quantities. Coming for the deduction part, as we are having in the plan for the exterior walls, there are 2 doors, 6 windows and 3 ventilators. When we put those dimensions of the door, windows and ventilator, we are getting the quantity of 18.45. The net plastering, net outside plastering, when we need to calculate, it is 154.325 minus 18.45, which is 135.87 meter square. This is the net outside plastering. Now, coming for the last quantity, which is woodwork for doors and windows and ventilator. So, number of doors are 6, D1 is 1, windows are 6, ventilators are 3, which is 1.2 by 2.1, then 0.9 by 2, 1.5 by 1.4, then 0.6 by 0.45. When we multiply this quantity, we are getting so and so quantities there. When we add up these particular quantity, we are getting 30.33 meter square. That is the woodwork quantity required for doors, windows and ventilators. This is how we calculate each and every item separately, the quantities of each and every item separately. Thank you.